o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, first of all, we are going to say that we will be announcing the final lecturer for LADS.
Exciting.
That is coming up very, very soon with kind of like a scary little video coming up to announce who the final lecturer is. We're going to be appearing at LADS 2017, which isn't long now, Wayne. 24th of September.
24th, yep. Last time of the month.
In Sutton Coldfield, Birmingham. So hope to see you there. News coming up, who that final lecturer is. First up, though, on the Wizard Product Review this week, we've got Made in Taiwan, Ben, Bottled. It's the Cap and Bottle Revolution.
Yeah, good little thing, this.
It's quite neat, isn't it? Should we do it? So you've got a normal Coke Zero-style bottle.
Yep.
You remove the top from the Coke Zero. You take the cap, full view, nothing else inside your hand, and you can actually take that cap and push it magically into the bottle. And it goes in the bottle as cleanly as that. And during a presentation, of course, you can now take a knife, an X-Acto knife or something like that, cut into the bottle and remove the cap and then give it to the spectator for examination. It's a solid plastic cap at that point.
They're immediately going to go and try and push that in there.
They can't put it through there. You can do it with the label on, you can do it with the label off, you can do it with a completely clear bottle. Another thing you can do as well is start, it's a more advanced handling that's taught on the digital download, where you start with an empty bottle, you then grab the bottle here, it's empty, and you take a cap and you tap it here, then kind of come away and the bottle cap is in there. But
I like the way you've done it actually, Dave.
It's,
like
it's quite simple, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. To unscrew that cap, balance it on there, get everybody gathered round. It's one of those coffee shop style type moments when you're out with your friends having a quick drink, put that on there and bang it, it's in there.
I remember Mike Close had this routine that I read about, I think it's in one of the workers' booklets. I read about it about 20 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's a routine for cigarette through coin, where you get a guy who's holding the coin on top of a bottle to kind of block the entrance to the bottle, and you put a cigarette, not politically correct these days, but a lot of more people used to smoke in those days, inside, and you would pass the cigarette through the coin, and you'd have this like dual effect going on. The guy who was holding the coin, who couldn't see, he was blindfolded by people, he was amazed how it had got in there, and then when other people told him how it was done, they said, well, the dude just pushed it straight through the coins, and that seemed unbelievable to him. So they had this argument going on. So you could easily create a presentation like that. And that is one thing that I do like about it, the fact that the effect is kind of clear. You do that. You could have somebody holding the bottle all the time whilst you push
you could
it
have
into
it gathered
the bottle.
Around there.
Yeah.
You could actually put a napkin over the top of that as well, make it into a right puzzle.
Yeah, make it more of a puzzle. Yeah. And then when it's inside there, it does seem absolutely impossible. It does look impossible. And
well, to get that out, you've got to cut the bottle.
You can't do the usual coin in bottle thing
and do this shaking out. Yeah.
And it looks great. It looks absolutely impossible.
Quite durable as well, I reckon.
Yeah, the gimmick is made very, very well.
Yeah, really good.
The only thing I would say about it is I'm not sure about the clarity of the effect. And one thing that I'm always keen to get across when I perform is I like people, spectators, to have a good understanding of what the effect is. Obviously, as magic, we kind of break the laws of science.
Yeah.
And I think they have to fully understand what is going on here. And if they don't handle all the props to start with, which you could do but would add to the handling, I don't know if they know for sure that you can't take a cap and ram it hard enough and get it in there.
Well, yeah, they're not. But the idea of that is that when you take that out, you hand it, you cut this open, you hand it back, they're going to do that. They are going to say...
But that's my argument. That's what I'm saying, Wayne. At the moment you do the magic...
Right,
do they understand? Yeah. Are they going, oh my God, that's incredible at that point?
Well, maybe.
Or do you have to go to that whole extreme of finishing the trick, handing them the props, and then go, oh, actually, you can't actually do that? but the clarity of the fact is not, not strong enough at that moment.
Maybe you could take the lid out and you can balance it on the top and you can tell people what you're going to do.
Yeah.
I'm going to put this cap in that bottle. Just make sure it doesn't fit in there. No, I didn't mean that way. I meant through the bottom.
Yeah.
Then you could do it that
well,
way.
Well, it's all horses for courses. What we can tell you is you've probably already done a little bit of research. If you're interested in buying this, you probably know what you're going to get here.
Yeah.
And we're here to tell you that the gimmick is very, very good. Mm. It's made really, really well.
Very well made.
If you want to do this routine and you want to clearly put a cap inside a bottle, then with empty hands, take out an X-Acto knife, cut it open, take the cap out, hand that cap to somebody and put the knife away in your pocket, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
There's probably no other better way to do this. It is super, super clean. I'm actually really impressed with this.
Yeah.
When I saw the video, I didn't see anything original at all. Hairball into the bottle. Cap in bottle, hairball in bottle. How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it 86.
86? I'm going to give it 85. I didn't think I was going to like it, but the gimmick is great. Well, obviously, we're talking about LADS coming up. And once again, we are going to announce the final lecturer at LADS very, very soon, as well as a worker of the week coming up very, very soon. Lots of dealers at Magic Live.
Yes.
You're coming to Magic Live next year, aren't you, Wayne?
I will.
We're going to see Wayne at Magic Live next year. Lots more going on behind the scenes to make that happen. Maybe you'll find out about that on social media very, very soon. But this is one of the dealers that were at Magic Live. They didn't seem to have anything new. In fact, that was kind of a criticism of Magic Live this year, the dealers. A lot of the dealers didn't seem to have much new. There wasn't any real buzz in the dealer hall, apart from our new effect, which comes out in a month's time.
Yeah.
And I'm not just saying that. Wait till you see the quotes, because it was the talk of Magic Live. Lots of top people, Bobby Motta, Rampin.
I'm proud, mate.
Even Chris Angel saying this was the best thing they saw at the Magic Live
Chris
convention.
Angel.
But I was just performing it. I wasn't actually selling it at the convention. I was just showing it to a few people because it's launched at the LADS convention. And wait till you see the quotes, wait till you see the trailer, wait till you see it demonstrated at LADS. It's probably the best thing I've ever come up with based on an idea of yours.
Yeah.
And it is such a commercial piece of magic. It's unbelievable. Yeah. I wish we could tell you more, but we will very, very soon.
Exciting.
It's launched at LADS. This company, João Miranda and Julio Montoya, Flash Gum, they were at Magic Live. I don't think they had anything new. The last thing this company had out that I thought was very good was the Astonishing Bottle. Do you remember the Astonishing Bottle with the big bottle of Coke?
That's it, yeah.
Great prop. Still haven't found a use for it, but I love it.
Yeah.
I absolutely love that prop. I think it's brilliant. But since then, they seem to have brought out a lot of effects that use this very similar principle.
It's very similar. It is very, very similar.
It's almost like they've learned how to make this gimmick. They've learned how to make it very well. It's made very well.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. There's no doubt about it.
We did have the Sharpie effect with the circling things on a page.
Yeah.
But that wasn't theirs, but there you go.
No. With this, though, they get to choose three separate cards. They can hold it out, and a couple of things.
With a bit of handling, the cards vanish from the deck.
Yeah.
But that's certainly not happening with a gimmick. You need to use sleight of hand.
You do, yeah. With this, though, it looks great on camera, as does the other effects using a very similar principle that they have already brought out. I think with this in a real-time performance, for me, I'm not too sure this is going to be that good.
Well, his live performance on the download, you get downloadable instructions, of course, that last about 35 minutes.
Yeah.
And the downloadable instructions, it didn't give me much confidence when I saw him. He looked a bit rough with the handling. The trailer looks great, of course. Lots of snappy cuts of the gum changing into the cards and that kind of thing. But there's something just from a routine point of view that doesn't make much sense to me. This kind of, I've had three cards chosen, and you know, when you talk about three cards being chosen, I always go back to that Simon Lovell effect, which is just absolutely unbelievable, which you need to seek out. Do you know the one with the three cards under their hand?
Oh,
where you
right,
have the mystery
yeah.
card.
Yeah, like, yeah, yeah.
That's a miracle. Yeah. You don't need to be messing around with gum. We need to find out what that's called. But basically, the idea of this effect, it's a Simon Lovell effect, I think it's in his book,
yeah.
is you put a card under their hand before the trick even starts. Remember?
Yes.
And then, you get three cards chosen, one of which is signed. You find, you could probably reconstruct this yourself, you find each card in turn that's not signed. So you find like the five that's not signed, the two that's not signed. And as you find those, you put it back under the spectator's hand with the mystery card.
Yes.
And then at the end of the routine, you say, well, I found the five, I found the two. But do you remember I put a card under your hand before it even started? And it's the signed card. Three cards. If you're going to do a trick with three cards, that's the one.
That's what
anyway, back to Flash Gum. Where you have three cards vanish from the deck. And then you go, I know, I'm going to make a card appear on the top of this chewing gum packet.
Yeah.
Because that's what you'd do if you're a real magician. So you go bang and it appears on top. Like Wayne says, looks great on camera. We're not going to take anything away from that. When you watch the video download, if you've already got this effect, you'll know what I mean. It's just kind of awkward when he gets it out of his pocket and he's got the cellophane on there and he's holding it in his hand and all his shoulders are like this and he's holding it in his hand and he goes,
he does say on the video, he does say on the downloadable instructions that it is angly. He does say that. But at least he admits it.
Yeah, it is angly. It is angly.
It's very angly.
It's tough to do.
Yeah.
But it looks great. It does look good.
You're going to put it on if you're allowed to put it on your...
yeah, there's no rights reserved or anything like that.
You
know,
social
that.
Media, you want to put a video up, it is going to look eye-popping. But to walk around performing it for a worker, I'm definitely not going to be doing it.
No.
Too much setup, too much angles.
And the gimmick will need repairing after a short amount of time. I played with
although
it.
Although this is well made. It's very,
it's
well,
very
made.
Well made.
Brilliantly made.
It just needs repairing after about 10 or 15 performances. The gimmick starts to get a bit weaker.
Yeah.
I'm sure you know what the gimmick probably is.
Yeah.
But it works very well and it looks great. And what does look good is the fact that when you've got the chewing gum packet, you can see the top, you can see the edge, and you can see the back.
Yeah, you can.
And you can take the chewing gum out. It looks great.
Mm-hmm.
Then the card appears on top, and then snap, the card appears. The two chosen cards appear top and bottom as well, leaving the chewing gum in the middle.
Yeah.
Those cards can't be examined at that point, but you probably wouldn't need them to be because you're just revealing the chosen cards. For me, there's just something missing. It's not...
Doesn't feel like a routine construct. Yeah. I don't know what the gum's about, that kind of thing, you know.
We're going back to that Simon Lovell effect, which you keep banging on about. The thing is, that's a routine that makes sense as a worker. We're going to have three cards chosen. We're going to put this under your hand. Straight away, there's this mystery. What is this card? Don't look at it. We're going to keep it a secret. Here you go in, take three cards, look through. They've disappeared. There they are. It just seems a bit empty.
Chewing gum, playing cards, I don't get it.
There doesn't seem any justification. There doesn't seem any reason to do the trick from a routine point of view, which is why we're saying that it probably works best just as a quick clip on social media.
Yeah, it's great for that.
However, before we go around in circles again, I will say I'm not going to use it, but the quality of the gimmick is very, very good. So if you like what you see on the screen, and you're not too worried about the routine not making too much sense and people analysing it later and going, yeah, well, why would you do that anyway? You might like what you see here.
Yeah.
It's not for me, but it is made really, really well. Do you agree with that, Wayne?
I totally agree with it. If you want something to put on social media, on one of your show reels, on a little bit of little video or something, then, yeah, you've got something really eye-catching.
It's why a nice moment.
Why it turns to gum is just another thing. What are you going to give it, Dave?
I'm going to give it... I want to give it a little bit more because I do like it, but I'm never going to use it, so I'm giving it 77%.
Okay, I'm going to give it 65%.
Yeah, don't be put off, though, if you like what you see.
Brilliantly,
mate.
You won't
be disappointed.
Very eye-popping, yeah.
It's nearly time for Lads 2017, 24th of September. Make sure you get to worldmagicshop.com and reserve your place right now for the UK's largest one-day magic convention. Although we do have a little get-together on the Saturday night where there'll be a Saturday session hosted by John.
By John, yeah. I really
John
like
Kerry.
That.
We'll be there on Saturday night looking after the Saturday session. If people want to jam, we're just trying something different this year. John said, could he come along and kind of host like a session? It's not really a lecture. This is a chance to sit down with one of the best thinkers in the world of magic and maybe jam, try out new routines, see some of the stuff that John's got on offer that we'll have a dealer stand at, lads,
it's
obviously.
These moments just before, when we've all gone to these lectures, that I remember being a teenager, going along there and sitting down and people like Tommy Wonder was sitting next to you. It's that happening all over again for many other people. It's a brilliant opportunity to learn something.
To sit down. So it's well worth getting a space at the hotel, checking into a room the night before so you don't travel on the day as well. I believe there's a special room rate. If you ring up the hotel, which is the Ramada Jarvis Sutton Coldfield, and say that you would like to stay over and get a room the night before, sit in the bar till the early hours while we're putting the set together. And then the lads' convention starts the next day. Luca Volpi will be doing a brand new lecture on mentalism. One of the world's leading mentalists, the greatest magical thinkers, and a recipient of the Merlin Award as I think Europe's top mentalist or something like that. He got the Merlin Award for very, very recently. Tom Wright and Aaron Jones are doing quite a unique lecture.
This is the one for me. This is the one for me. This is going to, I'm telling you now, this is going to be brilliant.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, can't wait.
But maybe our next lecturer will be the one that you're excited about seeing.
Oh, yes.
Because, well, let's let him announce it for himself. This is this year's star lecturer at Lads 2017. Here we go.
Hi, I'm Morgan Stribler, and I'm going to be at LADS 2017. You won't believe the lecture that I have in store. If you haven't purchased tickets yet, you can do so at worldmagicshop.com. See you there.
That's actually a little bit scary, isn't it?
A little bit off-put. A little bit got me a little bit worried.
A little bit scary.
A little bit worried.
Ooh. No, in all seriousness, Morgan Strebler is going to be here for LADS 2017. He's got some new material as well. He'll be going through some of his well-known stuff. He'll be there the night before in the bar if you're staying in the hotel. He'll be hanging around
the night before.
At the convention. If you're not too scared by Morgan's pitch there for his appearance.
We were a bit surprised.
Then it's going to be a great convention. Yeah. He is one of the. He's a genuine character.
Yeah, he really
and,
is. Yeah.
His thinking and his style of mentalism is just unbelievable. And when you spend time with Morgan socially, which of course you'll be able to do at LADS, you see how powerful his magic is.
Yeah.
And if you ever get him to perform for laymen, and I saw this myself on Hollywood Boulevard, when he performs for laymen and he does his original material, it is absolutely unbelievable. Yeah. And people are terrified. They really buy into his character. And there is so much to learn from this guy. The fact that he's doing a lecture at LADS, it is going to be great. We tried to book him a few years ago. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. But this time it's all sorted. The flights are booked. He is nailed down. He is coming to LADS 2017.
It's going to be great.
And it's going to be a great convention this year. We will see you there. Eagle the Seeker has bought out Tarantula 2. We're not going to say what it is too much, because I'm sure you know. Yeah. Watch the Wizard product review. You must know what these things are all about. You can do a lot of cool effects with this, can't you?
You can do, yeah.
Like borrow a ring off somebody, spin the ring around, and then it starts floating in midair, hand to hand, and then somebody holds their hand still and it can drop float down over and drop onto their finger, which does look incredible.
It does look amazing.
It looks brilliant, especially when your gal does it. There's a routine on the digital download that lasts just over an hour where it's very similar to Spooked, actually. I'm not sure he's got permission from Nicholas Einhorn, but it's like a haunted deck on the floor where the card jumps out.
Yeah.
Same effect as the spinning with a lifesaver or polo mint where it floats up directly into his mouth and various basic animations like a bill that floats up hand to hand.
Yeah, yeah.
So what you've got here is a very, very well made gimmick.
It is really well made.
If you haven't seen this kind of thing before, I guess there's kind of two reviews that should be going on here. One if you're completely new to this and one if you've had the original Tarantula. If you have the original Tarantula, The overwhelming thing that's new is the fact that the battery is rechargeable now with the USB lead.
Yeah.
And that means that it's good for apparently 100 performance. Does it say engagement jobs?
No, it says...
Does it say 50 jobs or 100 performances?
It says 50 jobs.
Yeah.
It all depends how many jobs you do, doesn't it?
Yeah, really? What if your job's a trade show and you're doing it 500 times a day? I don't think it will last that long. But I think 100 performances is what it says before it needs recharging, but it doesn't take long to recharge. You can certainly do it in the car on the way to the gig. It works very, very well. You know what the gimmick is, obviously, IT. And it uses that IT with a motor, and that motor can be locked, and you can hold all the gimmick in your hand totally invisibly, and you can't see anything at all. Everything is invisible to the eye because they don't know where they're looking. The effects themselves, I tried it with a banknote and a playing card, and I don't know if English banknotes and playing cards are a lot heavier than the bill, but I did struggle to make it rise up like he does with the dollar bills. But the locking mechanism, where you have the IT in a certain position and you lock it with your fingers and then make it float, looks very, very good.
It does look brilliant.
The only thing I would say about it from a working aspect is I don't do it myself but I've tried the routine that Tom Wright does with the spinning coin, where he spins it and it then drops to the floor. And I do like that a little bit more, because I'm not just biased because we brought it out and it was Tom's handling to that effect. I do like it a little bit more because you're completely free with your hands.
Yeah.
And I like it that the anchor point is somewhere else. It's not actually in your hands. So you're completely free and you seem completely clean when you're doing it, and your hand seems a little less awkward. Oblivion just is a better effect for me.
Yeah, really.
But I do think the quality of this gimmick is very, very good.
It's brilliantly mine.
What are you going to say about
it? Gonna be,
can you be constructive without saying too much about it?
Yeah, you know what? It's going to be the add-on of recharging it is going to be brilliant, isn't
if
it?
If you've
you know, going out knowing that something takes batteries and always got that in the back of your mind, now you can just go out and plug this in. It's just give it that top up, can't you?
If
you're going to use all the nice ideas that you had with it before, don't just do it just to make a banknote float from one end to the other. Use it for, you know, doing that ring spin and that kind of stuff. Use it, because I only ever see him do it.
Yeah, I think if you learn that effect, it is a great bit of eye candy. And I think if you were going to get the tarantula too, I think if you were to master that effect, it's worth getting it for that one effect, because it does look absolutely incredible.
It really does.
And like you said, though, I've never seen anybody apart from Tom Wright and Yigal Masika do anything like it and make it look as good as Yigal does on the download.
I've only ever seen people trying to practice it, like in the club room at the Circle, and dropping it about all over the floor, doing it properly. Practice it, sit down, buy it, work it properly, and you have got a really lovely bit of eye candy. Just for that one effect, it's just brilliant.
If you like the tarantula, the original, and you use it, you're going to want to get this, because it's better made. The locking mechanism works really, really well.
It fits, doesn't it? The fact that
it's rechargeable, and crikey, hats off to the guy. You look at the gimmick and it's so well made. It really is a piece of art.
He spent money.
A lot of investment has gone into this.
And Good for him.
I'm surprised, actually. It's so cheap. You might think it's expensive, but when you look at the technology inside, you think, actually, I have to go and make this now, and I have to go and research this, and I have to get this manufactured. Hats off to the guy, because it really is a great job.
Yeah.
It's just whether that investment is worth it to you. I've said many times on the Wizard product review, if something's £100, the first time you use it, it's £100. The second time you use it, it costs you £50. If you use it four times, it's £25
each.
If you've got something you use and you constantly use it, it ends up paying you back tenfold. If it's something that's just going to sit in your magic drawer, it's never going to pay you back.
What a waste. What a waste to throw it in the drawer, though.
If you know that you're going to use this and you want to learn, you want to study and you want to practice those effects, yeah, go for it. I didn't think I was going to like it, but the quality of the instructions, the quality of the gimmick, it has improved. It's better than ever.
It is.
I'm going to give this 85%.
Okay, I'm giving it a little bit more. I'm going to give it 87.
It's good. Better than I thought, actually. Really well made. This one is actually getting a worker of the week. Kind of a strange worker of the week. The automatic milk glass. We were very impressed with the quality of this, weren't we? It really is a quality, well-made gimmick.
Another well-made gimmick, yeah.
It's nice to see, actually. We get a lot of products that come in, and they're all based on the same kind of principles and something that can be handmade by people. And it's nice to see products that are actually manufactured.
Yeah, they spent money on it.
Made very, very well.
Yeah, done a bit of research.
And it's not also nice to see something that was out many years ago that was kind of old-fashioned, had that really old-fashioned tumbler look to it with the etched lines
in it.
And then, you know, the ones that were 70s and 80s magic and you get the tumbler effects. And now what they've done is taken it, you get a couple of stickers with it as well. And as you've seen on the trailer, when you put the clear stickers on there, it looks identical to a Starbucks Frappuccino glass. And, basically, the gimmick's inside there as well that you need to use. I thought it was silica gel, but the gimmick's actually inside there. When you put the sticker on there, identical to a Starbucks Frappuccino glass.
It is, really, yeah.
And the effect with this gimmick is it can be completely full and then completely under your control, automatic, because of the extra gimmick that you get with it. The contents will diminish up to 80%. So you could do this like literally on the side here. You could just click your fingers and it would start to go down. Great on video. I used to use it many years ago in a puppet routine when I did kids' parties. Yeah. And I wish this was around then because it looks... You could make so much more of it with your puppet, like say anyone to Starbucks or something like that. And you literally put this in the puppet's mouth and the liquid goes straight down. Visually, you can make the liquid vanish by magic. You can produce it somewhere else. There's a lot of possibilities with this, but as just an incredible piece of engineering and the quality of the gimmick, I'm
really
so impressed with this.
So very, very, very well made. It's got... I can see... Once those stickers go on there and you are out and about... you're going to knock people out with
that. It looks exactly what it's meant to look like. And the fact that you can put it down and then just click your fingers and then it slowly just start to descend. And the fact that we're not doing it, we're just saying this kind of happens, was a problem I had with the downloadable instructions, actually, which were 6 minutes long. I'll tell you what, the trailer's great for this. A bit weird when you start to see cows being milked and that kind of thing, but the actual effect on the trailer looks great.
Can you imagine being in a coffee shop and that happening? Could you imagine being in a coffee shop and you're just sitting there with your mates and you got this little drink going on, you put that down and say, watch this. Really?
It's unbelievable. I think TV magicians are going to be getting this because it's a great moment for a sting or something like that.
Yeah.
Great for social media videos. I think if you were using it in a performance, the example I gave for children's entertainers with a puppet is absolutely brilliant. Because I used to use it myself, so I know it used to work
and get
a great reaction.
Yeah.
The only issue I've got with this, and why I have to mark it down, or this would be really high, is the download was awful.
Mm.
It was really bad.
He
didn't go to any trouble you would expect on the download for him to take you through the process of how you prepare it. Step by step and say, this is what you do first, and show him filling the glass up, showing him how he prepares it. No, all he did was sit at a table, similar shot to what we've got today on the Wizard product review, no real close-ups, and just sat there and went, this is what you do with it, and then do this, and honestly, it works. And yes, it does work. It does work really well, but it would have been nice to see it actually explained step by step on the download. They've got a great product here, and you guys You really let yourself down with the instructions. You should have tried a lot harder. I want to give this a lot more. Although we're going to give it a worker of the week, because the quality of the gimmick really is fabulous.
Yeah.
I'm only giving this 91%. I want to give it a lot higher than that, but I can't, because you really let yourself down on the video instructions.
Yeah,
only 6 minutes. It's just described, go and do this. Show us what to do. You've got a video, you've got a camera there.
You do have to. You have to be precise. As you and I know, when we're making our instructional DVDs, instructional downloadable videos, you want to be as thorough as possible and put in other little ideas that you've tried and tested because you've been out and used it. And so by seeing this, it makes me feel like he hasn't used it, although it's a brilliant.
But he has.
But it gives you that impression. If you didn't see that and you saw that video, you think, not too sure. I'm still going to, you know what though? I'm going to give it 90%.
Yeah.
Because it really is so well made, but I do agree with you about the instructional video.
Stick the thick straw in there, it's going to look brilliant. So 90% from you, Wayne. Good scores. Would have been a lot more, would have been 97-98%. So I really do like this gimmick. It's the sort of thing you leave on the side, ready for video that I might make for corporate companies and that kind of thing. I don't think I'll do it in a show, but it's the kind of thing great in a show reel that's just a little bit of fun. They just see the liquid coming down. I really like it. It's getting a work of the week. Lads is coming up with Morgan Strebler. Before recently we've had Nicholas Lawrence lecturing at the Lads convention.
He was good.
His lecture DVD is available as a worker special this week from worldmagicshop.com. If you order the automatic milk glass from worldmagicshop.com and you order before Friday at midnight, you'll be sent automatically along with your order Nicholas Lawrence's live lecture from Lads. So
right
many
here.
Things on there. There's the
card under box gimmick.
The card under box gimmick, which you love. Yeah. The on-off, I don't know if I can do it at this angle.
You do it well.
It looks great. Yeah. I use that all the time where you apparently
remove your little finger.
And he's got lots of extra tips which appeared on the live lecture with Arnold.
How's everybody doing? Good? Put it on and just pull it right through. The cool thing is this really is your Instagram. This really is your picture that's been there for months. Put it inside my hand like this, just watch. Yeah, I hope you guys like it. Thank you so much for coming out.